Hey everybody, this is Dr. Flight, and in this short little video, we're going to talk about advertising methods and a little bit about the campaigns, with a strong focus though on advertising methods. And we're going to look at a variety of different ways to use the advertising tool as a way to communicate. So we'll have things like paid advertisements and joint advertisements and promotions and things like that. So in general, what we want to do is use a collection of tools to be able to get a message across. And so what we'll do is outline some of those tools in this brief discussion today. Let me know if you have any questions. Look forward to hearing from you. Thanks. Okay, so we're going to talk a little bit about and think about how nonprofits can specifically design and use tools in the communications process. We might focus this on nonprofit advertising techniques, but we'll walk through a number of different tools that focus on advertising and focus on developing efforts towards communications. So, in a nonprofit, marketers have a number of different options that they can choose from. However, there are two fundamental goals that most nonprofits are going to face when they think about their offering, which is somewhat unique to for-profit organizations. First of all, nonprofits are going to want to focus on position their brand, their offer, or their name specifically towards their target audience and the general public. So by doing so, we build awareness and top-of-mind knowledge and such about exactly that, the brand, the offer that's being made, or the name of the organization. So this is akin to what a for-profit organization would do in the positioning process, where you bring your product to your intended market. The aspect that's unique to nonprofits, though, is the second goal that nonprofits often have, and that is a need to educate the public and turn sentiment towards the social cause in which they advocate. So it's not only that we want to promote our brand or our offer or service or product, but in a lot of cases we have to also promote the social cause or what we're advocating for a mission as well. So that's something that's unique. A for-profit organization, take Apple. Apple promotes their iPhone, which is a telephone, but you would rarely see Apple promoting the phone industry overall. They don't need to, or they don't really have a reason to build awareness for the industry, but rather they build awareness for their specific product that they have to offer. So this is a uniqueness for nonprofits. They're often charged with building support for their cause, simultaneously building support for their product as it is. So we're going to walk through a number of different activities and advertising methods and different ways that we can build awareness for the firm from an advertising perspective. So one way is for us to simply pay for advertising. This is common. This is not unusual. So any paid form of non-personal presentation or promotion of our product or service would be something that we would think of as paid advertising. So television ads, radio ads, print advertising, advertising on the internet, any type of advertising where you pay for it and you have a spot. Now, the benefits here are that you control the message that you send. So there's no other third party involved. You control the content and you produce the piece that will deliver the message and all of that. So certainly we have a lot of control over the message. Second, typically with paid advertising, we want to reach a large audience. So we think of it as mass marketing. So we're reaching a lot of people with the same consistent message. And as a result, we have a lower per exposure cost. So we're reaching a lot of people. The upfront cost to do advertising like this may be expensive, but because we're reaching so many people, the per unit cost can be lower. Another way we could do this is if we joint advertise, or we have a partner that we advertise with. So it's a formal advertisement. However, we have a partner that pays for the message placement, and it is usually in conjunction with that partner's advertising campaign as well. So we may actually team up with a for-profit organization, and that for-profit organization may run an ad and may go ahead and place our name or offer along with it. So since the partner's already paying for advertisements of their own brand, they've already incurred that cost. So to tag our name along with it, or to build in some promotional aspects for us, is really kind of like a non-added cost to them, but we benefit, or the nonprofit benefits from that added exposure that they're able to provide. Some cautions, though, we want to lay out as we move forward, and when we specifically think about advertising is a proven method to build awareness. However, beyond building awareness, strict advertising is not always the best method to use if we want to convert our clients into actual behavior. So keep in context what advertising does for you, and that's build awareness, generally speaking. Advertising and promotions cannot be relied upon at their own or within themselves at the expense of other communication methods. So in other words, don't spend all your money on advertising and not spend any money on, say, direct appeals or personal appeals or direct mail or a promotion or some public relations activities and things like that. Advertising is not a cure-all or end-all. It only serves a certain purpose. Finally, one note of caution is that advertising can be extremely powerful, and in the long past, some marketers and some advertising folks have engaged in overselling or deceitful advertising or some disingenuous advertising behavior. So we want to make sure, obviously, that we're not getting involved in something that's unethical, where we're overstimulating and overmotivating the marketplace to a bad outcome or to an extreme. So the combination here is this idea that the general public usually feels like a sense of trust for nonprofits, and in fact, they'll often believe a nonprofit much more quickly than they would believe a for-profit. And if you combine that overconfidence or overtrust with the nonprofit with deceitful advertising, then you get a stronger than normal influence. And so, again, this is something that we need to be careful about, that we don't overuse the power that advertising can actually play. Okay, so we talked about joint advertising, also mentioned about paid advertising. Other things we can do are promotions. So these are things that we put in our toolbox of activities that we can do. Promotions are short-term incentives to encourage the performance of a behavior, such as a purchase or adoption or some behavioral change. Short-term incentives come in the form of some type of added benefit or a lowered cost for the client or for the marketplace. So we might lower our price, we might lower the costs, we might lower some disincentive, like what the customer would have to pay, and simultaneously we might increase the benefits that the customer may get, and that will ultimately induce some behavior that's positive. Fourth item here would be something akin to personal selling called personal persuasion. So one-to-one oral presentations of information about our offer or our brand. And we do this directly to a prospective target audience member. So it's like one-to-one sales. personal selling, or personal persuasion. Now, keep in mind that this is often used to make a close, to make somebody, to help somebody commit to an actual behavior. It tends to be a very costly or expensive way to communicate because you're spending your time on a one-to-one basis. So bear that in mind. Moving forward, unpaid advertising or PSAs or public service announcements, any form of advertising where space or time for the ad is provided for free. So this is very, very common with media where a TV station may offer time on the air for a nonprofit to put a message. Or they might promote a message for free because you're a nonprofit. There might be an area in the newspaper where there's ad space that's devoted for nonprofits. We might call these public service announcements or PSAs. So this is a way to get your message across using one of these mass media options, but for a free placement cost or fee. Now you still have to produce the ad, so you still have to create the ad that's going to be displayed, and that costs money. So there's a production cost involved, but the placement of the ad may be free in that regard. Another item here to talk about would be publicity. So publicity falls into the category of public relations. So publicity are non-personal. They're also non-paid usually. Reports, articles, or other communications produced by some media outlet or outside agency or party. So when others talk about us, so when we have a reporter write an article about us, or when we have a brand advocate talk about us, then that's creating interest and news, and it's getting information out about us. So when we have a local TV channel run a news story about us, then that'd be like public relations, and it instills goodwill and things like that with the public. So publicity would be yet another option. The final option we can talk about would be something that would be similar to blogging or active use of social networks on the internet. These are non-formal communications, so they're not like advertisements. They're not necessarily scripted, although they could be. But these are communications that are content-based, which we're creating in a digital or internet format or platform. So blogs, so tweets, little stories, content that you put online using your website. While becoming ubiquitous and possibly overused, digital delivery is certainly an integral part of messaging campaigns today. No doubt about that. So using these networks and digital platforms to create opinion blogs, again, personal network, brand engagement, getting people involved with likes and retweets or reposts of your information spreads your information for you in a viral type of a manner. Okay, so these are different ways, different tools that we're going to have in our promotional advertising toolbox, methods that we can tap into, that we will tap into in order to create an integrated message that's going to reach our market audience or our target audience in a lot of different ways. In a real quick manner, let's talk a little bit about the advertising process when we're creating an advertisement and we're talking about creating a message or a message campaign. We know that there's a communication process, but let's also talk a little bit about what we do as a manager when we're creating this message. So first and foremost, we want to set advertising objectives. So we want to be able to identify our client market, want to understand how to reach them, how frequently we have to reach them, and understand who they are we're trying to reach. So this is like your target market type of work that you're done after you did your segmenting. After that, we want to talk about how much money we can spend and how much we have to work with in terms of devoting towards the messaging campaign from a money perspective. Most organizations use some type of a percentage of sales, but this is, we're talking about a nonprofit here. So nonprofits are a little quirky because they may not have a sale. And what they might need to do is what's called an objective task method. And that's preferred, actually, where we decide what our outcomes are going to be. And then we work back and figure out what we need to do in order to achieve those outcomes. So if I want to do a message campaign and I want to reach 90% of my market and I want to reach them 5 times, I want to do some type of promotion and something like that, I'll look at what my media will cost and then calculate the actual budget needed in order to run the media that will achieve those goals. That's called an objective task method. So then what I can do is I can take that dollar figure and go to donors and I can ask them for that money, or I can fundraise and say, look, this is how much money I'm going to need, and move forward from that perspective. Once you identify your budget, once you know what your objectives are, then you can craft your message and select your media. Now, a lot of times these things are outsourced, and the actual organization doesn't do it, but we hire somebody outside the firm to do this. But from a messaging perspective, there's going to be a lot of different types of messages that we can tap into. So, the design of the message, the appeal of the message, the execution style of the message, all of those things kind of come into play. And then when we're selecting the media, what we're talking about is if we're going to use, like we said, like a promotion or advertising, if we're going to do TV or radio or print, or if we're going to do this online with a social media network, if we're going to Twitter, or Facebook, we're going to use our website. Those are all different types of mediums. And so we choose multiple mediums or media to carry our message. Finally, once we launch the actual campaign, we need to evaluate the advertising effort. So while we're developing our message, we may do some copy testing. We might do some other testing to see the effects of the message. We might test the actual mediums that we're using, and then finally, we're going to test to see how effective the actual message was in eliciting some type of behavioral change. Okay, so this is a big process. I don't want to minimize the dimensions and the intricacies of the process. You can spend a whole semester in an advertising class talking about this process. So there's lots of pieces here, and I know we're just kind of walking through them quickly, but these are the key points to know and understand from a nonprofit's perspective that we do all these things. So to summarize then, nonprofits' advertising and promotional focus should be on their brand and on their, offer. Keep in mind though that the secondary notion is that they may need to also engage in social cause awareness as well. So they're not only promoting themselves, but they're promoting their cause as a whole as well. And that's like a dual challenge that nonprofits have that's very unique to them. There are plenty of different a variety of things to use. We've talked about like paid advertising, joint advertising, promotions, personal persuasion, unpaid advertising, publicity, and then digital direct contacts. And then finally, we talked about the advertising management process. So this process was broken down into kind of four chunks, but five components. So objectives, budgeting, creating the message, choosing the media, and then finally evaluation. Okay, so this has been kind of a quick rundown of different options and advertising methods and in an advertising campaign specifically. So reach out to me, let me know if you have any questions, and be sure to just follow along, read in the chapter, and take notes. And you can obviously rewind and listen to this again. And let me know if you have any questions. Thanks.